tends to get the fat cells moving a little more, oxidizing those fat cells when you're doing some cardio. I'm not saying that you have to do...
What's up? 筋肉ハヤトです。さあ今日はナチュラルプロの減量中の有酸素見ていきましょう。減量中、有酸素はしますか？僕はします。映画鑑賞の時間にしたりしますね。今回はナチュラルプロのクリさんがハイキングをしながら有酸素の考え方について話をしてくれています。細かい方法などに目を奪われがちですが、基礎基本も改めて確認していきましょう。後半では日常の活動レベルについて少し話をしています。最後まで見ていってください。どうぞ。
Alright, the other common question I get all the time is, do I have to do cardio to lose weight? And the answer is no. You don't have to do any physical activityBut it helps you create a larger calorie deficit in order to lose more body fat. You know, for example, if you're maintaining on 2,000 calories while, you know, doing a very low activity level, like you're relatively sedentary, then you have to eat 1,500 calories a day in order to lose around a pound a week, and that kind of sucks. You know, 1,500 calories a day is not very much food. So if you were to do 400 calories of cardio or just increase your activity level,then you could eat more like 1,800 calories a day, 1,900 calories a day, and lose the same amount of fat as if you didn't do any cardio and you were eating 1,500. So, yeah, also, your body tends to get the fat cells moving a little more, oxidizing those fat cells when you're doing some cardio. I'm not saying that you have to do, you know, 5 sessions a week or anything like that, but it's good for you anyway. Like, it's good for your cardiovascular system. That's why it's called cardio.Yeah, so it doesn't really matter what time of day you do it. You know, figure out what works best for your schedule. But I always recommend either separating your cardio from your weight training or doing it after, because you don't want to do a long, hard, 30-minute medium to high intensity, or, you know, even if it's a low intensity, you don't want to burn through all your glycogen doing your cardio and then you go to lift weights and you're weak. You're depleted. You want to, because, you know, if your goal is like bodybuilding,or just having the best looking physique that you can have, then you want to focus on your weightlifting sessions to be about performance. You want to track your lifts and you want to make sure you're getting stronger. And if you're doing cardio before that, before your lifting session, then you're not going to be as fresh and you're not going to be as ready to go. So, you know, now it's the opposite. If you're actually a runner and you're preparing for a race or something, then your main focus should be your performance on your cardio. So it just depends on what your goals are.But I like to do cardio either on my rest days, like today is a rest day from the gym, or on completely separate from training. I like to train in the morning, I like to do cardio at night.
How do you know how much cardio to do?
So that's the thing, just like anything, just like knowing how many, you know, what to set your macros to, it's all about your progress and making adjustments based on your progress. So if you're losing half a pound a week and you want to lose a pound a week,then you could start with something like 3 sessions of 300 calories a week. You know, start that as your baseline. And then, you know, adjust your calories based on that and until you reach your goal. There's no like magic number that I could give you or say, you know, 2 sessions of 200 a week is the way to go.
さあ、いかがでしたでしょうか？根本的な考え方が伝わったでしょうか？1500キロカロリーはちょっと少なすぎるような感じもします。ただ本当にトレーニング以外の活動量が低すぎるとありえなくはないかもしれませんね。ここでの活動量とは簡単に言うと、一日中走り回っている仕事、一日中座ったままのデスクワーク、この2つを比較すると分かりやすいのではないでしょうか。有酸素やジムにいる時の消費カロリーを上げるのもいいですが、ジムにいない時の活動量も考えに入れてあげるとより減量が進むかもしれません。行き詰まったらそのあたりも見直してみましょう。みんなは減量中に大事にしていることはありますか？コメント欄で教えてください。僕は血糖値を大事にしています。最後まで見ていただいてありがとうございます。感想や動画のリクエスト、チャンネル登録お待ちしています。ではまた。